Question 62. Sales means turnover and profit during the year 2018 was between 20 lakhs and 2 lakhs. 20 lakhs is sales and 2 lakhs is the profit. The corresponding figures for the year 2019 was rupees 30 lakhs and rupees 4 lakhs. 30 lakhs is the sales and 4 lakhs is the profit. What is the PV ratio? Again, we have to. The formula for PV ratio is a change in profit divided by change in sales. Change in profit divided by change in sales into 100. Now, 2019 profit is 4 lakhs and 2018 profit is rupees 2 lakhs. Change in this one, rupees 2 lakhs. And change in sales, 30 lakhs and previous sales, 20 lakhs. Difference is 10 lakhs. 2 lakhs upon 10 lakhs into 100. It's in the 20% is the PV ratio. We find the answers 20%. Answer C is correct one. Now fixed cost. Formula is fixed cost. Sales into PV ratio minus profit. Sales rupees treated 20 lakhs, PV ratio 20% and profit rupees 2 lakhs. Okay, now 20 lakhs into 2% is 4 lakhs minus 2 lakhs. 2 lakhs is a fixed cost. 2 lakhs is a fixed cost. Now see the answers 2 lakhs. Option D is correct one. Now what is a BEP? Break even point. Formula is FC upon PV ratio. Fixed cost upon PV ratio. Fixed cost is 2 lakhs. PV ratio is a 20%. It means rupees 10 lakhs is the BEP. Now see in answers. Option B is correct one. Now we go to next. What is the sales to earn a profit rupees 5 lakhs? Formula is that sales fixed cost plus desired profit. Desired profit divided by PV ratio. Fixed cost is 2 lakhs. Desired profit rupees 5 lakhs divided by PV ratio 20%. It means 7 lakhs upon 20%, it comes 35 lakhs is the answer. Now see, option B is correct one. Now, what is the profit or loss when sales rupees 25 lakhs? Formula is profit is equal to sales into PV ratio. Sales into PV ratio minus fixed cost. Sales rupees 25 lakhs, PV ratio 20% and fixed cost rupees 2 lakhs. It's a 5 lakhs minus 2 lakhs, it's a answer is 3 lakhs. 3 lakhs is profit. See in answers. Option D is correct one. Now what is the variable cost when sales rupees 40 lakhs? Variable cost percentage is a 100 minus PV ratio. It's 80% variable cost percentage. Now in question, 40 lakh sales into 80% is the variable cost. It's a 32 lakhs is variable cost. C in answer 32 lakhs. C is option correct one. Now next question. Question 63. Selling price rupees 20 per unit, direct material cost rupees 5 per unit, direct labor rupees 2.5 and variable overheads 100% of direct labor means 2.5. Now total variable cost 5 plus 2.5 plus 2.5, it's a rupees 10 per unit. Now selling price 20, variable cost 10, difference is rupees 10. 10 rupees is a contribution per unit. Now see, First question, what is the contribution? Now 10 rupees contribution per unit. See here option D. D answer is correct one. Now PV ratio. PV ratio formula is that contribution upon sales into 100. Contribution rupees 10, sales rupees 20 into 100, it's a 50%. Now see in answers, option B is correct one. What is a break-even point? Break-even point formula is that FC upon PV ratio. Now see, fixed cost rupees 40,000. 40,000 divided by 50%. Rupees 80,000 is the break-even point. See in answers, option A is correct one. Now BEP in units. BEP units formula is fixed cost upon contribution per unit. Fixed cost is 40, contribution per unit is 10, answer is 4,000. Now see in options, option B is correct, 4,000. Now profit or loss when sales rupees 4 lakhs. Formula is that profit is equal to sales into PV ratio minus FC. Sales rupees 4 lakhs, PV ratio is a 50%. Fixed cost rupees 40,000. Two lakhs minus 40 rupees 1,60,000 is a profit. Now see in answers, option D is correct. Okay. Now we go to question next. Question 64. Sales volume 30,000 units, selling price to be 12, prime cost to be 6 per unit, and variable overheads to be 2 per unit. Prime cost means variable cost 6 plus 2 variable overheads, 6 plus 2 8, 12 minus 8 is a rupees 4 contribution per unit. Contribution per unit. First question, contribution per unit. See in answers, option B is correct. Now what is the PV ratio? Formula is that PV ratio contribution upon sales into 100. Contribution 4, selling price is 12 into 100. It comes 33% and 33%. See in answers, option A is correct one. Now what is the break-even point? FC upon PV ratio. Fixed cost rupees 50,000. PV ratio is a 33.33%. It means 1,50,000 is the break-even point. We find out the answers. Option C is correct one. Now BEP units, formula is that FC upon contribution per unit. Fixed cost rupees 50,000, contribution per unit rupees 4, answer rupees 12,500. Now see, option A is correct one. Now what is the margin of safety? Formula is that actual sales minus sales at BEP sales. See, actual sales 30,000 units into 12, 3,60,000, and BEP sales rupees 1,50,000, 3,60,000 minus 150, answer comes rupees 2,10,000 is the answer. We find out the answer is 2,10,000. Option D is correct one. Now we go to next question. Budgetary sales rupees 2x60, raw material cost 30%, raw material consumption will be 78,000. Now stock of raw material remain 3 weeks period. 78,000 divided by 52 into 3 is a stock of raw material rupees 4,500. This is answers we see in questions. Option A is correct one. Now next, raw material consumed to be 78,000. Supplier give 5 weeks credit. What is the amount of sundry creditors? Same like this one. 78,000 divided by 52 into 5 weeks. Answer comes rupees 7,500. We see in answer sheet. Option D is correct one. Now we go to question next. Total cost of production rupees 2,34,000. Finished stock remains in stock 2 weeks. What is the stock of finished goods? 2,34,000 divided by 52 into 2 weeks is the answers. 2,34,000 divided by 26. Answer is 9,000. We see in questions answer sheet. Option C is correct one. Question 75. Total cost of production rupees 2,35,000, 34,000. Customer will require 8 weeks credit. What is the amount of creditors? We have to divide 52 into 8 weeks. The answer comes to be 36,000. Now we see in answer sheet. Answer option D is correct one. Now next question 76 and 77 are the theory questions. Practical question 78. Net work capital rupees 15,60,000. Add for contingencies 25% on total work capital. 25% on a total. It means 1/4 on total. It means 1/3 on net working capital. Net work capital. Now see, 15,60,000 into 1/3. It means 5,02,000 or 20,80,000 is answer. We see in answer sheet. Option B is correct one. Now next question. Total cost of production 38,40. Period of allowed to customer is 1.5 months. 1.5 months means 1.5 months. What is the amount of sundry debtors? Divided by 12 into 1.5. Its answer comes rupees 4,80,000. Now see in option. Option A is correct one. Question 81. A company expected to produce and sells 60,000 units at rupees 5 per unit. It means 65 into 5 rupees 3 lakhs is total sales. Now raw material cost is 60%, direct wages 10% and overheads 20%. It means total cost percentage is a 60 plus 8, 20, 80, 80 plus 10, 90. 90% is the total cost of percentage. It means 90%, 2,70,000 is the total cost. Now see, question first. Total cost of production, rupees 270. Option D is correct one. Now cost of raw material. Cost of raw material is a 60%. 60% of these 3 lakhs. It comes 1,80,000 is the raw material consumption. See in option. Option E is correct one. Now credit period allowed to customer is 1 month. Customer means we have to take the total cost. Total cost is 2,70,000. 2,70,000 divided by 12 into period is 1 month. Its answer comes to be 22,500. Now see in options. Option B is correct one. Now credit period allowed to supplier is 1 month. Supplier means purchase of raw material. Purchase of raw material is rupees 1,80,000. Credit period 1 month, we are divided to 12 into 1. Answer is rupees 15,000. Then see in options. Option C is correct one. Wages are paid in 1 month earlier. Wages 10%. It's a rupees 30,000. Arrears period is 1 month. We have to divide 12 into 1. Its answer comes to be 2,500. And option D is correct one. Now question next. These are the theoretical questions. Just we go to next questions. Next practical question is 87. We read the questions. Sales 5 lakhs, cost of goods was 3 lakhs, net profit 84,000, operating expenses 2,000, non-operating income 6,000, average stock 50,000. We have to give the answers as, what is the GP ratio? GP ratio formula is GP upon sales into 100. Now, sales 5 lakhs, cost of goods was 3 lakhs, GP 2 lakhs. Sales rupees 5 lakhs into 100. It's a 40%. Now see in answers. Option D is correct one. Now what is the net profit ratio? NP upon sales. Net profit is 84 upon 5 lakhs into 100. Answer comes to be 16.8. Now see, option A is correct one. Operating profit ratio. Operating profit ratio, we have to find out net operating profit 84,000 and non-operating expenses 2,000 and less non-operating incomes rupees 6,000. It means 80,000. Now operating profit ratio 80,000 divided by 5 lakhs, it comes 16%. Now see, operating profit ratio, option B is correct one. Now what is the operating cost ratio? We know that operating profit ratio 16%, then cost ratio 100 minus 16, it means 84%. Now see, in option C, C option is correct one. Now what is the stock turnover ratio? Stock turnover ratio, formula is that cost of goods sold upon average stock. Cost of goods sold is rupees 3 lakhs and average stock rupees 50,000. It comes 6 times. Now see in answers, option D is correct one. Now question 88, 89, these are 30 questions. Question 90, net profit for the year 48,000, depreciation charge during the year 30,000, goodwill return of rupees 25,000, profit on sale of assets rupees 15,000. What is the funds for operations? We have to net profit add depreciation, add goodwill written off, and less profit on sale of fixed assets. We find out it. 48 plus 55, it means 30 plus 25, minus 15. Its answer comes to be 88,000. Now see in answers. Option A is correct one. Opening and closing balance of plant and machinery rupees 2 lakhs and 250 respectively. Depreciation charge during the year rupees 20. What is the amount of purchase of machinery? Now opening and closing difference is rupees 50. We have to add one depreciation 20. 50 plus 20, 70. 70,000 is amount of purchases. Now see in option. Option D is correct one. Opening and closing balance of depreciation rupees 3 lakhs and 5 lakhs. Accumulated depreciation on assets sold rupees 20,000. What is amount of depreciation? Difference is 2 lakhs. And we have to add accumulated depreciation to be 20. 2 lakhs plus 20, 220. In answers, option D is correct one. Now next, machinery costing rupees 70,000, book value 40, was disposed of for rupees 25,000. What is the profit or loss? 40,000 is book value, sale price rupees 25, 15,000 is loss. Now see in answers, option C is correct one. Now question next, opening and closing balance of provision for tax rupees 30,000, 40,000 respectively. Income tax provided during the year rupees 45. What is the amount of tax paid? Now see, difference of this one rupees 10,000 and current year's tax provision 45. 45 minus 10, 35. 35 is the tax paid amount. Option A is correct one. Machinery costing is 25,000, having depreciated 60%, it means book value rupees 10,000. Now see, 25%, 25,000 into 60%, it comes 15,000. Then book value rupees 10,000. Was sold at 10% loss. 10% loss it comes 1,000. Sale price will be 9,000. What is the amount of loss? Loss is a 1,000. Now see in answers, option D is correct one. A portion of machinery worth be 50, for which there was an accumulated depreciation rupees 1,000. It means book value rupees 49,000 was sold rupees 52,000. 49 and 52, 3,000 is difference. What is the profit or loss? 3,000 is profit. We see in answers, option C is correct one. Now opening working capital is negative, minus 50,000. Closing working capital rupees 40,000. What is the change in working capital? Now minus 50 and minus 40, minus minus plus, it means 90,000 is increase in working capital. Now see in option B. B option is correct one. Furniture opening and closing balance at cost 7,000 and 9,000 respectively. Depreciation is charged at 12.5% on average cost. Average cost means 7 plus 9. It's 16,000 and average means divided by 2, it comes 8,000. 8,000 depreciation is at 12.5%. Answer comes rupees 1,000. Then option A is correct one. Now question number 99 and 100. These are the three questions. Just we have to read one. This is the 100 and above 100 questions.